So first of all, we have this, which is the white light for the rear. Yeah, nice and bright, as you can see. So we'll use that in a second. But first of all, this is the main bit I was telling you about. Now, the big question a lot of people are asking, is it legal? Good evening and welcome to Lake Erie. Very low sunlight right now. It's getting close to sunset. You're probably wondering what the hell I'm doing on the lake at this time of night. Well, if you didn't understand the title, I'm here to review and show you the navigational lights I use late at night. I did a video a few weeks ago and I posted a little clip of it on the Ontario Sea-Doo Facebook page, and I had a few people asking where to get those lights from. Those lights are really, really cool. So I thought, you know what, when I got home, I thought I'm going to do a video. I'm going to get on the lake one night when the weather's pretty decent and put my lights on. So right now, this is my Sea-Doo as it is. They don't have any lights on whatsoever. But inside here, my lights, which I'm using, they're just tucked away down here, and they will clip on to the Sea-Doo when I need them, and I'll show you how that's done very, very shortly. So I'm going to be looking at the Attwood portable navigational LED lights. Oh, these are good waves. Look at these. Ooh, nice little swells coming in. I'll have to do some jumping in a minute. So we're about 45 minutes away from sunset, so I'm going to have a play around on the water, and once the sun goes down, I'll find a nice sheltered area and I'll put the lights up, show you, and hopefully get a nice shot of the Sea-Doo from a distance. So just show you how far these lights work from. And also I'll show you how easy it is to clip them on. And if you use a GoPro or another sport action camera, it is very, very easy, especially if you use a clip like this. So for the time being, let's go and have a little run around and wait for the sun to set. I can't go too fast, I got a coffee there. So I've got to be careful. I want to drink the coffee before I have some fun. But oh yeah, that's some nice little swells. I like this. There's a few people out over there. Let me just drink my coffee and then we'll go for a little rip. Oh, these are great waves for jumping in. Look at that. It's like riding a horse. All right, I'm out of the waves. I was up there a minute ago in the waves. Now I'm back just by the Point Avenue Boat Club here. The sun's now starting to set. What a beautiful sunset. Beautiful sunset on the water. So what I'll do now, because the sun's going to go down very quickly now, is set up the lights, quickly show you how the clip on, and we'll see how bright they are. And once the sun goes down, it starts getting dark, I'll make my way back over to the boat ramp legally. All right, this will do. All right, I'm clipping myself. All right, show you what I got in my little bag here. So first of all, we have this, which is the white light for the rear. Yeah, nice and bright, as you can see. So we'll use that in a second. But first of all, this is the main bit I was telling you about. All right, so basically, this is the light. It comes on a clamp. It's quite bright. So what I did underneath, I took the screw out. You see there's two screws there. Well, on the smaller one, they're both the same size actually, and what I did, I just put a drill piece in there to make it a little bit bigger, and then what I used was this little camera mount here, which is a quarter inch You can buy them off Amazon. They're like 10 bucks. You can get a pack with a few connections as well for maybe for 20 bucks. And basically, you want to screw a drill piece which is smaller than that and just keep it up to the size so that actually screws in quite nicely. A bit like this, if I can hold it. So basically, you just want to put the screw in, and into here, you'll just go like that, and you'll be able to just screw it right in. Oh, that's tight. Okay. Yeah, I don't want to go too tight because I don't want to break it. And then you'll use one of these horseshoe mounts for your GoPro, tighten it on, and it's easy as that. And all you do is, if I just remove my camera here, I'll put this back up here. All right. Now your navigational light, this, will just sit in here. And there you go. You now have your bow light, red and green, which I'll turn on very, very shortly when we need it. And now to put the back one on. Right, the rear light's gonna fit, it's gonna attach to this right here. All right, so this is how you mount it on. So basically, you just wanna open this up like that. Let's tighten that up a bit, it's come loose. And all you're gonna do, you're just gonna attach it to your back of your seat. See that? I've just got the back underneath here and this onto here. Just tighten it on like that. You can actually tighten it quite tight because this is very hard plastic on the Sea-Doo. There you go. That is on solid. Show you exactly what happened. Just screwed it on like that, nice and tight. And now we have our navigational lights. Now, the big question a lot of people are asking, is it legal? Now, it all depends. I'm going to go by North America here. It all depends where you are in North America. In Ontario, the province of Ontario, where I am, the Ministry of Transportation of Ontario, Ontario Ministry of Transportation, in the marine booklet clearly states it is legal for a personal watercraft to have navigational lights on. Everyone here in Ontario has taken the boater's license and able to get on here. So I had to take a boater's license to ride this here in Ontario. And I believe in several states in America, it is legal as well, but not all states. You're going to have to check your jurisdiction, where you are in North America, whether it's legal. And same with Europe, Australia, and Asia, and places like that. Just check your local area, your local laws for marine, for pleasure craft and personal watercraft, whether you can use lights on your Sea-Doo at night or personal watercraft in general. And if you can, you're good, you're golden. So basically what we're just gonna do now, well, oh, I just bumped into this, the channel marker. That's all right, 6 feet, 8 feet. So what we're gonna do now is just wait for the sun to go down. And once it goes dark, we'll make our way.
Nice.
See. Now, when you're out late at night, you really need to know where you are, your surroundings, and be able to navigate. Thankfully, I know this area quite well. And also, as a backup, I do have my Garmin, which has the tracks I've already used to get here. So I can, if the worst case scenario, the weather got really, really bad and the visibility got really poor, I can just crawl along and just basically follow the track I came in on. It'll get me back. And also, I can still see light in the distance from the buildings. I know exactly where I'm going. As I say, sadly, the GoPro, every time I point it forward, illuminates a lot, things a lot brighter. So maybe I'll tone it down a little bit in the post edit so it doesn't look as bright. But right now, it is, it's about half an hour past sunset and it's getting quite dark. All right, there we are, back at the boat ramp. And as you can tell, it's gone very dark. So yeah, I gotta get the Sea-Doo back on the trailer, which is pitch black over there. My truck is just there in the water. There's no light on tonight, so yeah, I gotta try and get it on there and guide it in. Still got some good waves here. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed that video. I hope it was very informative regarding the navigational lights. I'll put all the links to where you can purchase the Attwood portable navigational lights. Like I said, I got mine from Amazon about 18 months ago, and like $70. I have seen them cheaper now, and also Energy Power Sports, where I got my Sea-Doo from in Oakville, has it also listed in their catalog, and I'll put a link to that as well. So make sure you check that out. So anyway, that is it for another video. My name's Nigel, the channel's been Nigel's Cheap Vlogs, also known as a Lake Erie Vlogger. Feel free to contact me and leave me any questions you want rather on my social media, at Lake Erie. What was it, my Twitter account? Oh, Lake Erie Vlogger, that's my Twitter account, Lake Erie Vlogger. Or just leave a comment on this video and I'll reply to you pretty quickly, all right? Anyway, until the next video, stay safe and I'll see you soon. And that's it. That's another trip done. All right, let's fasten this up and get out of here.